Hello and welcome to the Tech and Auto Show, which is India's only show that satisfies your hunger for both technology as well as automobiles. I'm your host Siddharth Sharma, and we've got a power-packed show lined up for you guys this week. So without any further ado, let's get started. All right, that's our lineup on the show. And first up, what we have for you is one of the most awaited hatchbacks of 2018. Maruti has been teasing it for almost a year, and this year at the Auto Expo, they will be unveiling it and also telling us what the price on the all-new Swift will be like. We recently got our hands on one and test drove it in Lonavala. And up next, we get you our first drive review of the all-new Maruti Suzuki Swift. Is going to start with a big bang, especially for Maruti Suzuki, because the car that you and me were waiting for is finally here and we are getting to drive it. Yes, we are talking about the all-new Maruti Suzuki Swift, and we get you a first drive review on the Tech and Auto Show. Excited, Vicky?
Absolutely.
Now, one of the biggest things that has changed on the Swift is that despite having the same silhouette, it is still very refreshing to look at. Yes. What is your take on the design on the new Swift?
Design is something that, like they say, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Yes. Design is just one of those things that, you know, some people love it, some people don't. I feel that this new age, sort of slightly more pronounced rear lights, all of that, is a design norm that's coming in now. Yes. And we're seeing it on a lot of European cars as well. So what they've done is that they made it a little wider.
Yeah.
They made it sleeker. They've kept the design element of that floating roof, which we saw on the first Swift,
yes,
the original. And they've maintained that, and it looks really good on this, because now with that slightly more muscular stance, that floating roof element is really giving it that added edge. And the front end is something that we've seen on the Desire already.
Yeah.
So you've got those new look headlights, the DRS, the LEDs, you know, they're playing with their lights now.
Absolutely.
And it's coming across really nice.
For me personally, I still think that, yes, the modern new design element and design lines that Maruti is going for is brilliant. But I somehow liked, you know, the rear end of the Swift. It's gone more edgier now. It looks very Baleno-ish, you know, in a way. So that is something that I'm not that fond of, because I still thought that some heritage would still be kept in the car.
Don't freak out. There is a door handle for the rear doors.
Yes.
It's just not where you normally used to it on the door. It's now on the pillar.
It's very Chevrolet Beat-like.
But it does give it a nice clean line. It almost gives it like
absolutely
a coupe kind of look, no?
Talking about the interiors, Vicky,
yeah,
a lot has changed. You know, it used to have that simple, bold, dashboard, and now it's got much more trendier kind of a dashboard. What is your take on that?
Yes. The only thing that they've kept in common,
yeah,
is the all black. And speaking of that, the materials that they've used, the fit and finish, it's all gone up. We've seen this with all the new Maruti cars that have come out.
Yeah.
You've got a nice dash, soft materials. You've got that large console, your touchscreen interface right there, slightly towards the driver. And your dials, the AC dials.
They're very modern. They're very upmarket.
So upmarket interiors. On top of that, you've got great seats. Being a big guy,
yeah,
the seat goes back so far,
yeah,
that I actually don't have to keep it in the last notch, mm-hmm, like most other hatchbacks.
Yeah.
I actually have to move it up a bit to get my right driving position. So that shows that they've also played around with space a lot.
Let's talk about the driving bit on this. You know, I enjoyed the drive on the petrol engine. What was your take on that?
See, now the petrol as well as the diesel are the tried and tested engines. 1.2 liter petrol, your 1.3 DDIS. And both have been tuned to such perfection over time that they're just phenomenal units.
Yes.
Right? They deliver in terms of the performance, in terms of efficiency, they're silent, they're smooth.
Yes.
You know, there's really nothing to argue about with these engines, and why change a good thing?
Absolutely. And they are giving you a AGS transmission option on both the diesel as well as the petrol motor, and thankfully they've heard their customers. So AGS was also something that we really like on the new Swift.
Now, interestingly enough, Maruti's also put in high-strength steel on the new platform that the Swift comes with. So, no longer you get that old platform. It's more rigid. The NVH levels are also on the lower side. So, they've done a fantastic job over there. And when it came to handling of this car, wow, it was precise, you know.
Absolutely. The new platform is lighter as well. So, you feel that. Yes. You know, I think it's a 90-kilo drop between the older Swift and this one. So that's a pretty massive drop when you look at it. And when you're talking about small engines going into it,
yeah,
it changes the power to weight ratio also drastically.
Yes.
And that's where the peppiness is now coming out in such a nice manner out of these engines as well.
Final take, Vicky. What do you think this car is going to be priced at? Because that is something which is still in a limbo.
Good question. While the true answer for that comes out at Auto Expo, where they're launching this car,
yes,
I think guesswork would be to put it at least about 50, 60, maybe 70 grand lower than the Baleno. The Baleno being a Nexa product, right?
Yes.
But here you have a car that's competing with the Baleno except in size.
So that is our guesswork, that maybe it'll be starting at about 5 now and go all the way up to 8 lakhs,
yeah,
ex-showroom, of course.
Winner all the way. Nobody does an AGS like Maruti.
Yeah.
Those transmission units, they've really sorted out how to get that auto gear shifting to work for their cars, and it delivers. The engines, brilliant, as we said. It's fuel efficient. Overall, really nice looking.
Absolutely.
Okay. From everything, they've even paid attention to the diamond cut alloys on the, you know, on the wheels.
I love the new wheels. And of course, before we forget, of course, the new Swift comes with Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, mirror link, a reverse parking camera, and for safety, it comes with dual airbags, ISOFIX seats, ABS, EVD, the works. But still too early to say, this was our first drive review of the all-new Maruti Suzuki Swift. We will be getting you a full review, of course, on the Tech & Auto Show, and of course, we will be talking about this car, I think, throughout 2018. Now, if you go by my recommendation on the all-new Maruti Suzuki Swift, I would say that if you had to buy one, buy the petrol version and buy it in the manual transmission. You will love the driving experience on that car. But right now on the Tech & Auto Show, it's time for some technology action. And we've got someone really special on the show up next who also agreed to do a photo shoot with me. Who is she? Let's find out.
पता है कल कितना ढूंढा मैंने. मैं वापस लॉबी में भी गई थी लेकिन मेरा फोन कहीं भी नहीं मिला.
ओह
पता नहीं कितने कॉल्स आए होंगे अब तक.
हे आई थिंक मेरा नया फोन आ गया जो मैंने ऑर्डर किया है. सो कम गेट इट ना प्लीज.
ओके श्योर. थैंक यू.
ओह वाओ इट्स हियर.
गौहर रिमेंबर फोटो शूट इज इन 15 मिनट्स.
I know, but I can't wait to open it. I won't take time, okay? I promise. On a 9 light. So minimalistic. So clean, huh? So exciting. Oh, I love the body of this phone. The branding is so minimalistic. Itna kam hai. It looks so premium and classy, right?
Yeah, just like you.
Wow! The back has a mirror reflection. Mirror reflection at the back is gorgeous. Okay, let me see what else is there inside. The charger, of course. What's that? Ah, I think this is the SIM slot pin. I can't wait to power this up. Where's my SIM? I'm just gonna power it up. Oh, I love the display. I'm loving it that the front part of the phone is completely covered by the screen.
Yeah, it's really nice.
But you know what, Sunam? Wait till you see the best feature of this phone. It's got four cameras. 13 plus 2 megapixel camera, 2 in the front and 2 at the back.
What about the battery life?
From what I've read, I think is phone ke liye mujhe set par pure din power socket dhoondna nahi padega. I think, oh, call aa gaya. Hello?
Ma'am, I'm speaking from the set of the Beauty and the Geek photo shoot.
Yeah, I'm here.
Ma'am, I've been trying to call you for a while. There is a slight problem.
I'm fully ready. What happened?
Actually, the photographer's flight is delayed and we have no one to shoot this.
Is the shoot not happening?
I'm extremely sorry, ma'am, but I don't know what to do now.
Seriously.
I'm extremely sorry, ma'am.
I don't want to hear about this, okay?
Now what, Gauhar?
Mujhe kya pata, yaar. It's not like the solution is going to walk through the door right now.
Hey, Gauhar. Did you hear about the photographer?
And with that, it's time for us to take a very small break on the show. But you guys don't go anywhere because there's plenty more action coming your way on the other side. Welcome back, you're watching the Tech and Auto Show with me, Siddharth Sharma. Now, before going into the break, we had Gauhar Khan on the show, who was quite upset about the photographer cancelling the Beauty and the Geek photo shoot. But what happened next is simply unbelievable. Check this out.
Gauhar, photo shoot is in 15 minutes.
On a 9 light. Powered up. Oh.
Actually, the photographer's flight is delayed. We have no one to shoot this.
Hey, Gauhar. Did you hear about the photographer?
Yeah, I heard. I mean, yahan aao, and then I got ready for so long.
You know what? I told my friends that I'm doing a photo shoot with you. And now my 15 seconds of fame is gone. Hey, isn't that the new Honor 9 Lite? Hey, when did you get this phone?
Abhi abhi aaya.
And this is also the phone with the quad camera setup, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, I just got an idea. You know what? You just get ready and we'll do this photo shoot.
Huh? Sid, mera phone kaha leke ja rahe ho?
Aur iski intensity thodi si kam karna. Haan, ekdam badhiya. Yeah.
Sid, what's up? Yaar, mera phone leke aise bhaag kyun gaye?
Well, listen, if we don't do this today, we're going to come back here again. This phone here can actually save our lives.
We're talking about a professional photo shoot here. How can a phone camera do that?
Well, they've put in a quad camera setup on this one. But it also comes with a bouquet effect and they've put in some beauty filters as well. Let's try it, no? What have we got to lose on this one?
Fine.
You're glowing, man. See, I could never do that.
I'll teach you to.
Gauhar Khan shooting for me. I wish my friends could see this. Let's try something with the burst. Wow, man, the images on this one are really sweet and that bouquet effect is working really well.
One second, I want to see it.
All right, let's try a dual camera selfie.
Okay, come on. Now it's your turn.
Wait, I was just warming up.
Let a professional actor show you how it's done. Jai, one more. Arey, give me a little intense one right now. Thoda aur intense. Itna nahi yaar, if you're a tech reviewer, not a serial killer. Yaar, kya photo liye maine, seriously.
Camera ki tareef karo, apni nahi.
Fine. Hey, Sonam. Now, you take a picture of the beauty and the geek, okay?
I'm not a photographer.
Don't worry, Sonam. Just point and shoot, and this phone will do the rest.
Wow, Gauhar, your new Honor 9 Lite saved the day, man.
These are absolutely print-ready pictures, huh?
And look at that bouquet effect and the sharpness. It's just beautiful. Wow. Whoa, wait. The photographer's assistant is calling.
Hello. Ma'am, the photographer's flight just arrived. What should I tell him?
Well, tell him...
Tell him that we have packed up.
Yeah, that's right.
And now it's time for some automotive action. Now, Manav Sinha has been riding a lot of superbikes on the Tech and Auto Show, but this time around, we threw him a challenge. We asked him to ride a scooter and tell you whether it's worth your money or not. So he went to Honda and got their latest Grazia for you. Up next on his review.
Now, scooters are selling unlike ever before in India, and the one that sells the most is Honda's Activa. A variant of that comes with a 125cc engine as well. But Honda thinks that there is space for another scooter in that segment, in the form of the Honda Grazia. What's different with this one? And does it manage to make a good case for itself for your money? Let's take a look.
The Honda Grazia is powered by the same 125cc engine as the Activa, and that's a wonderful thing. That's because the levels of refinement of the engine and the drivetrain as a whole is simply fantastic. The power output from the engine is about 8.5 horsepower and around 10.5 Nm of torque. And when you add the fact that Grazia weighs about 107 kilos, which is fairly light, you have a scooter that feels peppy on the go. The best part though is that no matter how you ride the scooter, the engine never feels stressed. Speaking of stressed, what we didn't really like was the suspension setup, which often felt too hard when going over potholes. The seat too felt a bit on the harder side. But that's about all that one can nitpick about the Grazia, because everything else works great. Like the brakes. The variant we rode had a 190mm disc at the front, and when you combine that with Honda's CBS technology, you have great feedback and bite from the brakes. That's not it. Ergonomically too, the Grazia left us impressed. The floorboard has ample space and the riding position is relaxed as well. As for riding the Grazia, the scooter felt light and maneuverable, and tackling traffic in this is no strain at all. What's notable though is that Honda has given tubeless tires both front and back, and the wheels are alloys, giving the scooter a dynamic stance.
So on the mechanical front, the Grazia comes with a lot of tried and tested bits which work really well together. But on the features front, there are some which cannot be overlooked.
The most noticeable feature of the Grazia has to be the headlamps, which are all LEDs. This is the first scooter in India to do so, and the throw of the lights is simply the best in its segment. That's not it, the Grazia will catch your attention even from the back, thanks to that huge taillight along with the split grab rails on top of it, which gives it a sporty look. Honda has given the Grazia a dedicated compartment space which can be used to keep your smartphone, wherein you can charge it as well. But in order to do so, you'll have to shell out a few extra bucks, as the charging port is an accessory. When it comes to practicality, then Honda has fitted the Grazia with a seat release button, which sounds great in theory, but it was a bit flimsy on our unit as it didn't work all the time. Overall, the Grazia is definitely a looker, and the design will appeal to the younger section of the market. And it comes across as something that's fresh and new in the plain and simple scooter segment in India.
So to sum it up, the Honda Grazia comes with a good list of features and a very good engine on board as well. The biggest challenge for itself though was to establish an identity which is different from the Activa as well as the Access 125. And that it does. And when you combine all of these factors together, the Honda Grazia is actually a pretty good buy.
And that's about all the time that we have on this edition of the Tech and Auto Show. If you have any comments, queries or suggestions, feel free to tweet us on our Twitter handles. All you tech lovers out there, you can tweet us at News18Tech. And all you petrol heads, don't forget to tweet us at News_Cars18. We'll see you same time, same place next week, only on CNN News 18.